Hello friends, welcome back to my channel Techie Twins and this side Tanvi Agarwal. Today I'll be adding one more interesting topic in my testing series and it is bug life cycle or defect life cycle. Guys, this is very important topic for any software professional who is into testing field or for the candidates who want to make their career into testing. No matter what you call it, bug life cycle or defect life cycle, both refers to the same topic. Bug life cycle or defect life cycle is the set of states a bug travels in its entire life, and states may vary from project to project. The life cycle of the defect starts from the new state, that is from the time the defect has been created in any defect tracking tool such as Jira, Bugzilla, Rally or any other. After it is identified by the tester while doing the testing of any application and ends at the closed state after the defect has been resolved with any of the valid reason by the tester. Defect life cycle is followed for easy tracking of various states of a defect, making the defect fixing process quite systematic, and which in turn contributes for making the application defect free. In this video, I'll try to cover all the possible states of a defect which can be there irrespective of any project. First comes the new state. This is the starting stage of a defect life cycle. This stage comes when the tester finds a new defect in the application and logs it. As per the tester, it can be a defect, but its validation is still pending. The second state is assigned. This is the next stage after new state. The state of defect is changed to assigned when it is validated by the test lead once and has been sent to the development team for some fix. Now comes the open state. This state comes after the assigned state. The state of defect is changed to open state when the developer starts analyzing or investigating the defect for fixing the same. The fourth one is the fixed state. The state of defect is changed to fixed when the developer makes the necessary changes in the code and verifies the change that if defect has been fixed correctly. Now comes the retest state. When the developer fixes the code for the defect and sends it for testing, the tester retests the code at this state and verifies whether the defect is fixed or not and changes the state to retest. The next one is the verified state. The status is changed to verified when the tester retests the defect and finds that the defect doesn't exist anymore, means it's fixed. The next comes the closed state. After the defect has been verified by the tester and it is identified that defect is fixed, the state of the defect will be changed to closed, and it is the final state in defect life cycle. Now comes the reopen state. The state of defect is changed to reopen if after doing the retesting of defect, the tester finds out that the defect still exists and needs a fix. Now, the defect again enters into the defect life cycle and goes to the developer for the fix. There are also some other states in the defect life cycle in which the defect can enter, like duplicate state. The state of defect will be changed to duplicate if the defect has been raised twice or if the defect corresponds to same functionality of application. The state would be changed to duplicate by the development team. The next is deferred state. The state of defect will be changed to deferred when the defect that has been found is not that important to fix immediately and can be fixed later, or if the defect has no impact on the current release and will get fixed in the next releases. The next one is the rejected state. When the developer feels the defect is not a valid one, then the state of defect is changed to rejected. So friends, in this video, we discussed a very interesting and easy topic. I hope you liked my video. And for more interesting topics, please subscribe us so that you can follow our upcoming videos. If you have any feedback, do write us in the comment section below. Thank you.